Hello children, how are you? Look, I have brought something for you. Let's see if you can tell their names. So what is this? Yes, that's a circle. And here, a square, a triangle, a rectangle. Well done. So tell me, what are we going to talk about today? Make a guess. These all are different shapes. So today we will talk about shapes. And we will see various magics of these shapes. You know what? These shapes are just wonderful. Would you like to know how? Okay, so let's begin the fifth chapter of class 3, Shapes and Designs. But first tell me, can you make their picture? Come, let's try. You can make it with the help of a bangle or a container's lid, which is of round shape. A circle. See, it's round. Wow, absolutely round. So now let's make a square. All the four lines equal and straight. Absolutely equal. Yes. And now let's make a rectangle. Two longer lines and two shorter, like this. And now it's triangle's turn. 1, 2, 3, like this. Three straight lines. Well done. Well, now look around and try to find out some shapes around you. Okay, let's start with a circle again. Do you have any circle around you? Yes, try and find out. Oh, you can't see any? Okay, so let's do a magic now. Close your eyes. Yes, everybody, close your eyes. Now draw a circle on your hand with your finger. Yes, go on and on and on. Did you like it? Okay, so now open your eyes and try to find the circles. See, there is a circle in the fan. And that regulator button, it is also round. Also see the bolts around. They also look like a circle. Hey, your shirt's button. That's also round. And now, look into the mirror. Your eyes also have them. Now try to find more. Keep thinking and find more. Show them to everyone and also write or draw. Okay, now let's find out some squares. So first, close your eyes and draw it on your hand. A square. Four equal lines. Absolutely straight. Absolutely equal. Go on and on and on. Good. Now open your eyes and try to find out the squares. Is there any square in the door? Or that little window? Is there any square on the floor? Tiles in the kitchen? This wall clock. But look carefully, all the four sides should be equal. Absolutely equal. Only then we can make a square. Can a square be made with the help of fingers? Look, the two front fingers, joining them like this, we get a square. Okay, look for more. Yes, more. A bread slice. Think of more objects and write or draw. Now let's find out some rectangles. First close your eyes. Now draw it on your hands. Keep on drawing. Two sides longer, two shorter. Very good. Now open your eyes and find out. Yes, the door, the photo frame, switchboard. They all are in the shape of a rectangle. Elmira door. This wall, the tabletop, remote control, TV, the button on the remote control, the face of your book or notebooks. Good, good. Look for more. Do it all together and write or draw. Now let's try to find some triangles. Yes. Oh, can't find any. Not a single. So let's close the eyes first and draw it on your hand. A triangle. Three sides. 1, 2, 3. Make a triangle. Keep on drawing. Keep on. Keep on. Very good. Now open your eyes and look around. That bed sheet, curtains, or some clothes. Is there any design with triangles? An electric switch? Look at it from a side, left or right side, like this. The electric plug. Is there any A written on the book or some notebook? The sharp tip of a pencil also looks like a triangle if we see it from one side, or the nib of this ball pen. Do the two hands of clock make a triangle like shape? Oh, but they make only two sides. Let's look for more. Hey, your nose. Okay, why not make a triangle with fingers? Join the front two fingers of one hand with some finger of the other, like this. See now, we have made another triangle. Can you make these shapes with paper folding? Look, this is a piece of paper. It looks like a rectangle already. So tell me, how many edges does it have? Edges means the lines at sides, which it is made up of. Look, first edge, second edge, third edge, and the fourth edge. Total four edges. These two edges facing each other are longer than the other two, and we get a rectangle. Okay, how many corners does it have? Here, this is called a corner. This sharp one, like an arrow. Does it prick when we touch it? Just touch it and check. Ooh, yes, a little. Okay, so this is the corner. Now count how many corners are there. 1, 2, 3, 4. They are also four. Four corners and four edges. Very good. Let's make a square with this only. First, join one edge with the adjoining one, like this. You just need to fold it like this. Look, the corner in between has become even sharper. Good. And downwards we have two layers of sheets. One is longer while other one is shorter. So let's fold the longer one to make it equal to the shorter one. And now cut this folded part. Now open it again and see, our square is ready. Let's check if all the edges have actually become equal. Yes, they all are absolutely equal. And the line at which it was folded is its diagonal, here in the middle. We can also make another diagonal by folding it from the other corners, like this. That's great. Well, let's make a triangle with this sheet only. So what do we need to do now? Fold it again the way we had folded it earlier. And now our triangle is ready. If you want, you can open it and cut it at the diagonal of the square. This will give us two triangles, two identical triangles. Here, 1 and 2. Let's count its edges now. 1, 2, 3. And corners, they are also 3. Let us now make these shapes with the help of math sticks. A square, a rectangle, a triangle. Can we make a circle with straight lines? Try making it with these math sticks. No, that's not possible. To make a circle, we need curved lines, not straight. Well, let's play some games now. For this, you will have to make some pictures. But do remember, to make these pictures, you can only use the shapes. So let's make a flower, a circle, some triangles, and a rectangle. Now let's make the sun, a circle, a bigger one, and again some triangles. Here, now make a hut. A triangle, a square, a rectangle, and a circle. And the hut is ready. Now, let's make a tree. A circle, two more circles, and one rectangle. Hey, why not make it with a triangle? It will look even better. So tell me, how did you like this game? Now let's color these. Let's make some rules for coloring it too. Red in the triangles, green in the squares, blue in the rectangles, and yellow in the circles. So, did you see the magic of these shapes? Now let me show you a joker made up of these shapes only. You will surely like it. Look here. Oh, such a beautiful picture. All the shapes. And see this amazing joker. Wow, that's wonderful. We will color this joker according to the same rule. So children, let me show you another magic now. The magic of triangles. So look here and tell me, how many triangles are there? That's quite easy, isn't that? So just count and tell. That's one triangle, right? And now how many triangles? Two triangles. Look carefully. One, two, and this bigger one. This is also a triangle. So here we have three triangles. Okay, tell me now, how many triangles are there in this picture? 1, 2, 3. Are there only 3 triangles? Okay. So, are there only 4? Or is there some other magic? Yes, think, count and tell. Okay, should I tell now? Here we have 6 triangles. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, aren't they 6 in number? Okay, tell me, how many triangles are here now? 4, 6 or 8? And the right answer is 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Now, match these shapes with the right number of triangles. Now, let's play a game. With a square. So tell me, how many corners are there? We have already seen. A square has 4 corners. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, if I fold one corner out of these 4, then how many will be there? 1 taken away from 4. It gives 3. That's correct. Isn't that? Come, let's check it now. One corner is folded now. Count all the corners. Hey, not three. Now we have five corners. Okay, so now let us fold another corner. And see how many do we get now? Now there are six corners. If I fold one more, then we will have seven corners. And on folding the last corner also, eight corners. Well, see, if I fold all the four corners of a square, I still get four corners. Is that possible? Yes or no? No? Why not? Yes, it's possible. Look here. So we still have four corners. If you liked it, then let's play a game with rectangles now. Here is a grid. So let's make some rectangles in this grid. Look and tell me, which rectangle is bigger? Yes, think and tell. Number 1 or number 2? Let's count the number of boxes inside these two rectangles. Then we will know for sure which rectangle is bigger. Both have covered equal space, that is equal number of boxes. So actually, they both are equal. Let's see some more. Make the biggest possible rectangle in this grid. Count the boxes that it covers and find out which rectangle is the biggest. Now, let's have a look at some more amazing shapes. These shapes are such that when they are joined together with each other, no space is left in between and they cover the whole of the surface. For example, a square. See, there is no space left in between. And what about a rectangle? Yes, that's also right. And triangles? No, not like that. We will have to keep some triangles upside down also. Like this. Now there is no gap. Can we do this with the help of a circle? No, it leaves the space in between. Now, look out for some new shapes that do not leave any space in between when joined together. This hexagon, isn't that right? And this quadrilateral? Yes, again. Now look at this design. There is a gap. But if we arrange it like this, tell me, now is there any gap there? These all are the designs of tiles. Think of some more such designs and draw them. Here are a few examples for you. So look at them and tell me, which designs will not leave any space in between? This is number 1, this is number 2, and this is number 3. None of these, because they all will cover the space completely. Look here. This was the first one, this was the second, and this was the third one. Wow, these designs are amazing. Now, let me show you a very interesting game of these shapes. We call it a tangram. It's a very famous game. In your book, the shapes used in a tangram puzzle are given. Tangram with 5 pieces and another tangram with 7 pieces. Just cut all the pieces to separate them and try to make the shapes given in the puzzle. Also, ask your friends to do so. The one who solves it first will be the winner. Well, children, now answer some questions.
How many shapes of tiles do you see here?
1, 2 or 3? There is only one design in 3 different colors and it has made a stairs-like structure. Okay, can we make a stairs-like design by using just 2 colors? Yes or no? Try it. So children, now try to make some new designs of such tiles. This was your chapter Shapes and Designs. And we will meet in the next chapter now. Thank you. Have a nice day.